Find all the factors of 80 and find prime factorization of 80. What is the major difference between factors and prime factorization? Factors, we use multiplication table. And we use U-shape. Prime factorization, we use prime numbers. And we use our tree shape, like branches coming after 80. Let's try factors. So what we will do is we're gonna write 80 and we will ask ourselves a question. 1 times what number is 80? 2 times what? 3 times what? 3 doesn't go. We will not write it. We will skip those numbers which doesn't go evenly into the numbers. Which doesn't go evenly into 80, we're gonna skip all of those numbers. Six does not go, let's skip them. Seven doesn't go, skip them. Eight. Nine doesn't go, skip them. Notice one thing, 8 times 10 and 10 times 8. That means this is a repeated representation of two factors. 10 and 8 gives you 80 when you multiply them. So if you keep doing it, if your representation will be 16 times 5, then 20 times 4, then 40 times 2, then 80 times 1. So this one we're going to skip, and this is where we stop. So that's our signal to stop, that now you don't want to go furthermore. Sometimes if you have, let's say for instance, 36, and if you have 6 times 6, when you have both numbers are exactly the same, that is your stopping point also. Now we're going to make a U-shape using any color you like. And I'm going to start writing my factors from my upper left corner going down and then going up to all the way to upper right corner. So my factors 80 are 1 comma. Remember, we're putting comma in between because factors are individuals, okay? They're individuals, so that's why we're putting comma in the middle to separate them. Comma 2, comma 4, comma 5, comma 8, comma 10, comma 16, comma 20, comma 40, and 80. So these are the factors of 80. Prime factorization, we need prime numbers. So we're going to start with the smallest prime, 2. 2 doesn't work, then 3, then 5, then 7, and 11, like that. So let's make our first branch. 2 goes evenly 40 times. 2 goes evenly 20 times. 2 still goes evenly 10 times. 2 still goes evenly 5 times. 2 and 5, both are primes. This is where we stop. We can't do any breakdown furthermore. Let's write the prime factorization by drawing this little line from upper left corner going to lower right corner. So my prime factorization for 80 is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 5. But as you notice, 2 shows up 4 times. So 2 to the 4th power times 5. So this is our representation for prime factorization for number 80. Notice prime factorization, you have to have a time sign. Now one more thing. If somebody says, what if I write 16 times 5. Can this be a prime factorization? No, because 16 is no longer a prime. 2 is a prime, 5 is a prime. We don't care about the exponent, whether it's prime or not. That we don't care. But when we multiply them, these numbers must be prime. Exponents, we really don't care. Hope this will help you. And let's do 2 more examples for practicing. Okay? You start and then see your answer matches mine. Hope your answer matches my answer. Let's do prime factorization. We're going to draw branches starting from 117. So the smallest prime is 2, 3, 5, 7, 11. This is the order we go. So we're going to start with the smallest prime 2. Can 2 goes evenly into 117? No, because it doesn't pass the divisibility. Let's try 3. 7 plus 1 plus 1, 9. Yes. So 3 goes evenly into 9. So 3 has to go evenly into 117. So it's 39 times. Can we still use 3? Yes. These both numbers are prime. That's where we stop. So our prime factorization for for 117 is 3 times 3 times 13, which is 3 square times 13. And please notice it, 3 is a prime, 13 is a prime. Exponents, we don't care what we have for exponents, but this is a prime factorization for 117. Remember one more time. 9 times 13 is not a prime factorization. Why? Because 9 is not a prime. Hope this will help you.